a good delivery, full of length. That's gone for six runs. Welcome, you're watching IPL's Cricket Carnival on NewsX. I'm Ritanshu Bhattacharya, and of course the Indian Premier League Season 10 extravaganza continues. Nine matches already being played, several more still to come. And tonight we're going to discuss about young sensation Sanju Samson, who smashed the first century in this year's edition for Delhi against Pune. We will also preview match number 10, which is coming up in a few minutes from now. That's Mumbai Indians versus Sunrisers Hyderabad. NewsX brings you the Cricket Carnival as we discuss, analyze and bring you everything from the world of IPL. Virat Kohli's coach Rajkumar Sharma is joining us in the studio. Also joining me will be sports guru Himanshu Chaturvedi from New Delhi, and also Ritinder Singh Sodhi, who will be joining us from Chandigarh. We have a power-packed panel today, and we can't wait to bring you all the highlights from yesterday's game. First, of course, the key man of the match, or at least the key firework from yesterday's encounter, Delhi's Sanju Samson became the first centurion of the 10th edition of the IPL. Sanju Samson smashed 102 runs of just 63 deliveries. He scored the 44th century in the history of IPL, and he smashed 8 fours and a whopping 5 sixes in his majestic knock at the MCA in Pune. The youngster shared a 69-run partnership with Sam Billings before adding another 53 runs, of course, with Delhi Daredevils MVP Rishabh Pant. His splendid century helped Delhi seal the win against Pune by a mammoth 97 runs as Zaheer's side opened the account with two valuable points.
Yeah, in each and every format of cricket, I think you need to adapt according to the situation and respect the bowlers at some times and build a partnership, and you need to take singles as well. So you need to respect the bowlers as well. So you need to read the game correctly and react accordingly. I think, as I always tell everyone, that it's a very good blessing I've got from above, that Rahul sir is always there to help me, and it's a great confidence which he gives me. Like, he's a legend player, and if he comes and tells anyone that you are a good player and you can perform well, then that boosts you up like anything. So it has helped me a lot.
Rajkumar, first of all, I'm sure you must be very happy with yesterday's game. A lot of you, we all predicted Pune to win, although, but your heart was clearly with Delhi. Yeah. And it seems we should only follow our heart, as the saying goes. But of course, Sanju Samson, obviously, it was expected that if Delhi would win, it would be their bowlers who do the job for them. But Sanju Samson coming out and hitting that splendid century, that's something which was really unexpected and has become one of the highlights for this year already.
Oh, he's a superb player, and that is what he has shown in earlier years. He was supposed to be in Indian team very early, say about 3-4 years back, the amount of maturity and talent he has shown. But because he was slightly inconsistent, so he was not picked on the regular basis. But the way he played yesterday, the shots which he played, especially against the medium paces, that was superb. You know, he was in brilliant form, and he played all the strokes in the book, and brilliant batting, I would say. The best in this season.
All right, so the best in the season already, as Rajkumar is saying. Ritinder, do you agree with the view? Do you see a marked improvement in Sanju Samson? Of course, he has played a lot of interesting cameos and match-winning knocks earlier, especially when he was a part of Rajasthan Royals earlier. But this is his first big knock, his first century. Do you see the evolution of Sanju Samson, which now might pressurize the Indian selectors to look at him a bit more closely than what they have, how they have seen him before?
Yeah, Sanju Samson, Ritanshu, he was regarded as the next big thing in Indian cricket a few years back. He was considered to be put into the Indian team rather sooner, but somehow he lost the way, as Rajkumar sir has said. He was inconsistent, he was not getting runs, he was losing his opportunities. But yesterday, I think his train is back on the track. The way he played, the way he mastered his shots, That was exemplary. He seems to be the boy who's ready to become a man and to get into the Indian team. And I'm sure if he remains consistent, that's the key. He can't just sit on the laurels of yesterday's knock. Whole IPL is still there. If he keeps getting runs and takes Delhi to the IPL semi-finals or finals, I'm sure that this man will be noted in the notebooks and will play for India very soon.
Well, he's already shown the credentials to be a swashbuckling T20 player, especially with this knock. But as Ritendra pointed out, Rajkumar, consistency is the key. Now, assuming Sanju Samson achieves that level of consistency for the Delhi Daredevils here, if you would be a selector of the Indian cricket team, how much of a weightage would you give a person's performance in the IPL, especially in a team like Delhi Daredevils, which is not does not have a lot of star batsmen here? So to make an impact for that team, how much of an importance would you give it?
No, it is very important, especially if you are selecting a team for T20 formats. Then you would always like to count the IPL, you know. But on this basis, you can't take him in the test side. But since it is a T20 game, and if you are picking up a team for T20 India, I think he will be the contender for that place.
Indeed. Ritendra, again, I have to crystal gaze a bit. But the fact still remains, obviously the key highlights which a lot of hardcore cricket fans look at the IPL is to see the next big Indian talent. Now, unfortunately for the last many years, we haven't really seen the next team blue, or at least the blue player jersey wearing superstar coming out from the IPL format here. Do you feel Sanju Samson can be that person, especially given the fact that there seems to be a vacancy for a big hitter T20 batsman right now in the Indian team?
Look, Ritanshu, it is still very early days. As we have been talking, this man was talked about very highly, lost the way in between. But yesterday, he's back again with a bang. So consistency is the key. If he keeps on getting runs, and selectors will definitely be now watching very closely after yesterday's knock, because his form is there, he looks good, he's a very good fielder. And I'm sure that if he just keep working hard, because that's the key, he can't lose the way again. And selectors really see the consistency. And the season he had in Ranji Trophy, Deodhar Trophy, that is something of paramount that cannot be disregarded. So it depends as a whole, in totality, how he's emerging as a player. And if he is there getting runs in every tournament, I'm sure he should play for India.
Well, of course, all eyes will be on Sanju Samson in the games to come as to whether he can truly emulate what Rahul Dravid, his mentor, wants him to be. But let's not look into the past a bit too much. Let's now look at the future, because in about 20 minutes from now, Mumbai Indians will take the field. But before that, they had a bit of a milestone here. They celebrated their 10 years in the Indian Premier League that began way back in 2008. Seems a long time ahead. A gala felicitation ceremony was held for the decade-long participation in the competition, where they have consistently showcased cricketing excellence. Let's have a look at this video package.
The completion of 10 years of Mumbai Indians. I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Can we do something different? The first thing was, can we get the team together? The team is together, but we need to understand each other.
Really happy because of we went to the Mumbai Indians, then in the Wankhede, all the people are shouting as Malinga, Malinga.
You guys should imagine yourself, you know, in India's all top newspapers, front page, you guys lifting the cup.
Well, of course, Mumbai Indians along with Kolkata Knight Riders can be truly regarded as among the last few surviving giants of IPL, who have been there from year one and have done consistently well, and they have been two-time champions as well. But Rajkumar, it really has been a really interesting journey for Mumbai Indians. They were much fancied. They started off the first season with Sachin Tendulkar at the helm, of course, with the backing of Mukesh and Anita Ambani. They didn't do well. They had to rejig. Sachin had to leave the format. Then Harbhajan came in, and then finally Rohit Sharma came. It really has been for them a case of really rising to the top, working hard every step of the way.
They always had very big stars in their team, and yes, the support staff as well, their mentors, maybe Ricky Ponting, and a few big stars they always have. And they have always thought of late starter. In initial part of the tournament, they'll lose, and then they'll come back hard, you know. So that is what has been happening. But overall, if you see, they have been doing well in this IPL till now. You know, they have won it twice, and Rohit Sharma is leading from the front. Though he is not fired in this season, he got bad decision in the last game. But hopefully, if he'll you know, deliver, then they have got very good chance today even.
Ritendra, how important is brand Mumbai Indians for the IPL here? Because we discussed, it's the only, if I'm not mistaken, apart from KKR, it's the only surviving team which is a former champion and has been there from season one at this point. And obviously, with the influx of Bollywood superstars being brand ambassadors, obviously with Sachin being a mentor, with key people like Ricky Ponting and Anil Kumble all being associated with it, obviously I'm sure Mumbai is right now, if I could make the comparison, Mumbai and KKR are the Real Madrid and Barcelona of IPL.
Yeah, Ritanshu very rightly put in Real Madrid and Barcelona. Yeah, and the reason is that this team is star-studded. It is owned by the champ, and then they have champions like Sachin Tendulkar as their mentor. Their support staff is so huge, such big stars. Only sports staff can bring the goosebumps. So you don't need to go to players. And when we talk about players, they have Harbhajan Singh, Malinga, superstars, Rohit Sharma. Tendulkar has played for a number of years. So I'm sure that Mumbai Indians has played their part in IPL. They have been consistent. They were always table toppers in, if you talk about last few years. And this year, the tag of being slow starters is still with them. But I'm sure as the tournament progresses, this team is surely the one of the better teams, and they have the arsenal to go all the way.
Well, there has been a criticism, of course, that Mumbai Indians is the richest team, so they often find it quite easy to buy the success. But that will be put to the test, because tonight they make their home return form count when they face a stern test against defending champion Sunrisers Hyderabad in match number 10 of IPL season number 10. Mumbai, of course, would be ecstatic after the win against arch rivals Kolkata, but Rohit Sharma and company need to be wary of the threat Hyderabad possess within their all-rounding capabilities. The host will look up to the Pandya brothers, Hardik and Krunal, and also, of course, to Slinga Malinga to give them the edge. Meanwhile, Hyderabad will be confident in making a contest out of their under-the-star skipper, David Warner. With Warner, Yuvraj and Moises Henriques in form, Hyderabad's batting looks dangerous at the moment. And of course, remember, they also have the always dangerous Bhuvnesh Kumar and the old warhorse and sly fox, as many people call him, Ashish Nehra. They will be aiming to lead the bowling unit. Ritendra, coming to you first. Obviously, it is a big match for Mumbai. As you pointed out, they have not really been the best starters here, but this is really a mouth-watering clash here, because this gives them an idea of how well they really stack up against the big players here. Sunrisers Hyderabad have had a great season last year, defending champions. They look very strong. They started off the campaign on a high as well. It really would be a very good indicator for Mumbai to see where exactly they stand vis-a-vis the best in the league.
Look, a very important contest because it is as close as I think the one of the better ones in IPL. Because if you talk about Mumbai Indians lineup, they have all the star-studded players. But the fact is that Rohit Sharma is not firing. He got the bad decision in the last game. But still, we feel somehow he needs to get that touch back. And when we talk about Warner, he has been a champion. He has been a class apart. He can take the game on a given day away from the opponents. So he is in superb form. Henriques is playing well. UV is in flamboyant form. So this match is very difficult to judge that who will have the upper hand. But the starting point, I'm sure that Hyderabad, they have their nose ahead, but that too very slightly.
Indeed, and breaking news coming in at this point, we understand that Mumbai has won the toss and they are looking to field first. Rajkumar, your views on that decision?
I think they are looking for early wickets because both Warner and Shikhar Dhawan are their openers, and if the ball swings, if Malinga and Bumrah for that matter takes early wicket for Mumbai, so they are looking for some early wickets from Hyderabad, because otherwise they look very, very dangerous team. You know, they can chase any total because Warner and Yuvraj and Shikhar Dhawan and Henriques are capable of chasing any target.
So we have seen that strategy play a bit more often. Generally, teams prefer to use the strength in the second innings, whether it's batting or bowling. Obviously, Mumbai at this point feel that they need to see the big total, whatever total Hyderabad post up, and then go ahead, clearly indicating they're not very confident as to whether the bowlers can defend every target or not.
No, it's more of ball swings in the early part, you know, in Mumbai because of the sea. So I think they're looking for some swing and to take this, some early wickets so that they can restrict Hyderabad to a decent score which they can chase.
Indeed, Ritendra, the other important clash, and obviously it's something which often gets a bit underplayed, but it's very important to not underestimate the value of fielding, and that can often be the big difference between champion sides and the ones who are also runs. How do you see the Mumbai Indians fielding stacking up against explosive hitters such as David Warner and Yuvraj Singh?
Fielding is the key, because if you can field well, if you can save few runs for the team, the better it is, and we have seen in IPL upteen times, the better fielding outfit always reaches the last stages of the tournament. So somehow, Mumbai have a very good fielding unit. They have Jonty Rhodes, somebody in the dugout to support them. So what else they want? But you can't take Hyderabad lightly at all, because at times, if Warner keeps going, you don't need to field well, because then all the shots will be going above the rope. So it's very important for Mumbai to see the back of Warner very early in the innings.
Indeed. And let's now look at the venue. This is, of course, the most iconic Wankhede Stadium here. And Rajkumar, how important is that for Mumbai Indians? It's not just, I mean, not every team has the luxury of playing in front of their homes in the season of the IPL. And that too, playing at a stadium as iconic as Wankhede, does it bring its own pressure as well?
No, it doesn't bring a pressure. Rather, they would feel good that it is their home ground, and the wicket is very good. Like, you know, they can chase any target in that. If maybe even if it exceeds 170,
yes,
75, the wicket remains the same, and you know, it is good for batting in the later part also. So that gives a lot of confidence to the home side that we can chase a big score also. And that is why they want to take early wickets to restrict Hyderabad. Okay. And even if they get some big score, they have the potential, and the wicket is very helpful to bat, so they can always chase a big total.
Well, we're discussing strategies with Rajkumar Sharma and Ritendra Sodhi. We'll be looking at the Hyderabad side of the equation as well. But after a short break, stay with us. Cricket Carnival live here on NewsX. Welcome back. You're watching NewsX, and the Cricket Carnival is truly upon us. We are discussing Sunrisers Hyderabad versus Mumbai 11. Mumbai Indians. Mumbai has decided to bowl first after winning the toss, and we are expecting that kickoff soon. The big return, obviously, when it comes to Sunrisers Hyderabad has been that of Mustafizur Rahman. He was not there for the first few games, but he's obviously been the man who made the difference for Sunrisers Hyderabad in the champion season last year. He's back. And Ritendra, how important is that for Sunrisers Hyderabad in terms of team strategy, composition of the playing 11, as well as overall morale?
Yeah, Rahman is back, so that is icing on the cake, because this team is doing nothing wrong at the moment. They have all their batsmen firing. They have a very collective fielding unit. Bowling, fast bowlers are bowling all those important Yorkers. So I'm sure at the moment it seems easy for Hyderabad, unless Mumbai do something brilliant here. And Mumbai, they have won the toss, they are bowling first. It's very important to get Warner out in the first six overs. If Warner is there for the first six overs, I can assure you, Ritanshu, Mumbai is going to have a very, very tough time.
Indeed. Now, it's important, it's very interesting to see the person who Mustafizur Rahman is replacing in the team, Rajkumar. We expected him to replace someone like Ben Cutting, but he's actually come in the place of Moises Henriques, who actually had a pretty good match in the first encounter of Sunrisers. Sound strategy or something?
No, I think he's not fit. That is why he's been asked to sit out. But Mustafizur Rahman is a key player, you know, for Hyderabad. He has done so well in the last year, what we have seen. And he's a wicket-taking bowler who can, you know, take early wickets and death overs. He's the master of bowling in death overs. So overall, if you see, Hyderabad now has got a very strong bowling lineup with Ashish Nehra and Bhuvnesh Kumar supporting him as fast bowlers. And then they have Rashid Khan, who has taken most wickets in this IPL, leg spinner from Afghanistan, who has done so well.
Yes.
So overall, it looks to be a very, very balanced team, Hyderabad, and Mumbai will have to play very well to win this match.
Is that the key winning factor for Hyderabad? The fact that they are one of the very few teams amongst those playing in the IPL who have a very balanced team. They are not very batting heavy or bowling heavy. So they really have the option, even on a situation like this where they have lost the toss and they are going to be batting first. They really can back themselves because they have good players and players in form, players who have been playing for the respective countries in all three departments.
That is there. You know, balance is the key, you know, for any team. And fortunately for Hyderabad, they've got very balanced team. They've got good all-rounders. They've got good death over bowlers, good new ball bowlers who can take wickets. And then they have got a good leg spinner who always takes wickets. So overall, if you see their combination, that is very good. And that is the key for them, you know. And that has been the key last year also.
Well, as you pointed out, obviously, the other big aspect from Sunrisers Hyderabad, and I'll put this across to Ritin the first, is the fact that they are playing, the two out of the allocated four international players are from Bangladesh and Afghanistan respectively, and they are the much heralded players, Mustafizur Rahman and Imran Tahir. Now, coming at a time when there was this perception for a lot of teams that if you have to win, you have to pack your squad with Australian players, even though they are uncapped players with that, or then there was this trend, if I can say, of West Indian players after they started doing very well in the T20 format here. But this ability to think out of the box when it comes to team planning here, getting good players here, cheap players, and players who have a lot of hunger, fire in the belly to make a difference, especially from Afghanistan, Bangladesh, this really indicates how IPL has really evolved at this point as a global tournament within the.
Yeah, that is one reason, Ritanshu, that auction is so very important, how you pick your players, because at times we have seen many franchises in the early part of IPLs picking up bigger names, and then they used to come to know that those players are not available for certain part of the tournament. But now franchises are not taking any chance. They have their talent officers. They are going all around and looking at the domestic games, looking at the form of the players, and then they sit on the table and decide whom to pick, whom not to pick. So definitely, yes, Rashid Khan and Rahman, they are from those plannings which all the teams have done. And Hyderabad, they did their homework really well because they have got in these two very important players. And this man, Rashid Khan, the way he has been firing, the way he has been bowling, he looks a class apart.
All right, it's decision time, in which I try to put both of you gentlemen on the spot and get your predictions here. Let's get some statistics on the way first. Number one, the overall record between Sunrisers Hyderabad and Mumbai Indians is even at 4-4. But what's more important is that, A, on one hand, Sunrisers won the last two encounters last year. They were the defending champions. But they have never really won at the Wankhede Stadium. Do you see that playing a big importance?
Yeah, that would be there. Psychologically, they would be thinking that we have not won on this particular ground. But I think with the balance of the team, I think they stand a very good chance because bowling, I would say Hyderabad has got tremendous bowling lineup. And they are the favourite in this.
So you're picking Hyderabad to win?
Obviously.
Ritinder, obviously the other question also is that with you likely to become a factor and Hyderabad batting first, Mumbai chasing them, do you still go with Ritinder and believe Hyderabad have the advantage even in foreign soil?
It's important if Hyderabad get runs on the board and add to 170 or 180, then the Ritanshu, they have the bowling lineup to defend that. And the important fact is that Rohit Sharma, the champion of Mumbai Indians, he is not firing yet. And Hyderabad will only wish that he doesn't fire today too.
But who's your pick, Ritinder? Hyderabad or Mumbai?
I think I have clarified it. It has to be Hyderabad because they have all the firepower.
All right. So both of our guests who's going in for Hyderabad. We'll see in 3 hours' time as to how it goes. But the nature of IPL is so unpredictable that no prediction can really be taken and kept as money in the bank. But thank you so much, Rajkumar Sharma and Ritendra Singh Sodhi, to join us. We are leaving you with this very short montage. More news and updates coming up on the other side. Stay with us.
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be.
Six runs.